The Pac-10 football season is in full swing. Game two of the conference schedule here today in Pullman, Washington on the Palouse. The Oregon Ducks are up to number three in the national polls after an impressive win over the number nine Stanford Cardinal. Oregon falling behind early, but then coming on like a storm, rallying and shutting out their opponent for the fifth straight time in the fourth quarter. Today's game, though, a test to see if Oregon can avoid the dreaded letdown against Jeff Toole and the Washington State Cougars. So
Toole is a gamer. He loves the game, but the problem, supporting cast. He doesn't have supporting cast that he needs to win football games.
On the other side of the ball, LaMichael James. They call him La Heisman. Is it Spanish for the Heisman, in case you didn't know? LaMichael is off to a great start, more than 700 yards already. Boy, we're looking forward to seeing him today against a defense that ranks near the bottom in all of NCAA college football. We're about ready to kick it off. We got the sombrero out. The Ducks and the Cougars here from Pullman. There's some broken clouds. They say maybe a little bit of rain moving in later in the game. About 65 degrees. Very good weather for this football game. A little bit of wind behind the Cougars at this point, blowing in from the open end of the stadium here. There's our weather. Ducks have won the toss. They've decided to take the ball, and it drives it deep into the end zone, and Kenyon Barner will take a knee from there.
Well, if Darren Thomas wants to get the crowd out of it, he has to start fast. And you know, the last couple of games, the Ducks haven't started too fast.
Because Oregon runs so many plays, and they have so many possessions. A low snap, little reverse on first down, and there's nobody out there. One block. Gets outside the block. Huff stays in bounds and steps out at the 36-yard line. Thran, York, Holmes, Kaiser, Darian Weems back in the starting lineup. There's LaMichael James at tailback, Paulson. And Williams is available today at the tight end spot for Oregon on offense. Here they are, first and 10 at the 36. No running backs this time. The blitz coming. And flag is down, but also is the quarterback. I would imagine they decline this, Anthony.
Alex Hoffman, Ellis, is one of the best football players on their team.
Penalty is declined. Second down.
LaMichael now back behind Darren Thomas. They'll give it to LaMichael. He looks for a hole. Still on his feet. Picks up a couple of yards to the 30. Third and long. Their defensive line has been maligned, and they are injured and have a bunch of new guys in there as well, including the linebackers, Beck, Mizell, and Hoffman Ellis. Third down, 15 for Darren Thomas. Plenty of time. He throws it. Drops it short to Jeff Mayle. He's got a lot of room to get. Mayle comes up 2 yards short at the 44-yard line.
Keep everything in front of you. Let him catch the ball in front of you, and then come up and make the tackle. No yards after the catch.
They're going for it. LaMichael James trying to get to the corner. LaMichael dives. Let's see where they spot it. It's going to be close. Stretch it out. And he has the first down. It's hard to tell, you know, where the ball was. How about that, converting it? And the Ducks get quickly on the ball before they try to whistle it. And now there's a timeout. I think Washington State is asking for a challenge.
He's saying he has nothing to lose.
Washington State head coach is challenging the ruling on the previous play.
So we'll get a challenge at this. You'll see LaMichael go out. So it's hard to say where the ball is. Remember, the first down is not where you see the orange thing, the orange little carpet on the white part. You'll see the orange thing. That's not the first down. The first down is the chain. That thing that LaMichael just landed on, as you can see, it's about a half a yard ahead of where the first down really is. So the ruling on the field is confirmed, and Oregon has a first down.
Lost the challenge for the rest of the game.
So the Ducks convert after the holding penalty and the sack. Here's Kenyon Barner looking for a block. Gets one. Kenyon around the edge. Barner across the 40 to the 37-yard line.
You got blockers in front of you, and then you have to get off the block to make a tackle against Kenyon Barner. That's almost impossible.
Thomas throws right into the blitz. Jeff Mayle will pick up 8 on the play. He'll throw it to the outside. Too high for LT, 2-0. He finally does. And this one's likely going to LaMichael James. There it is. LaMichael with a nice move. LaMichael can't get back to the line, though, and they lose yards. And are they going to go for it again on fourth down?
Defensive end, he's coming down. LaMichael makes a couple people miss. But that's the key to a running back like LaMichael James. Everybody has to get to the ball carrier. It has to be a team effort.
Thomas throws it inside screen. Jeff Mayle has it. Mayle to the 20, the first down to the 17. Thomas keeps it. Thomas to the 10. And a flag comes out. Two flags, three flags.
Personal foul. Face mask. Number 10 of the defense. Penalty be half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
Out.
Thomas going to roll. Little shovel pass caught with one hand by LaMichael. He takes it to the one-yard line.
Yeah, the timing of that was just a little off.
Second down and goal from the one. Thomas gives it to LaMichael. He's into the end zone for the touchdown. LaMichael James. I think it's the longest drive of the season time-wise for Oregon. 4 minutes and 10 seconds. Ducks are going for two. A little swinging gate. Trying to force their way in. Do they get there? They do. The two-point conversion is good. LaMichael James. Ducks on the board, 8-0. Beard's kick comes down at the 2-yard line. Cougars bring it out. It's Carl Winston, tight end.
That's right. Ex tight end. The center snapped the ball right to him. And look at that leg power with Deion Jordan. He's a big guy now.
So here's Jeff Toole and the Cougars as they start out. Again, last week they had a lot of success. They'll try to run it here on first down and have a lot of room over the middle and a first down 15-yard pickup for the Cougars. Montgomery, Stormo, Carstetter, Blackledge, Barton are the skill players there. Of course, Jeff Toole, the quarterback, and we just saw Mitz also interchangeable at tailback. Toole going to throws it outside, and it's incomplete.
They're a team that they pass first and run second, but it was kind of odd. They ran on the first play of the game.
They'll hand the ball off and a big stop and a tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
The defensive line for Oregon is playing so good this season, getting off blocks. And he was unblocked there, so when he's an unblocked guy, you got to make the tackle.
As we've seen all year, the Grizzly, number 88, right in the middle.
I thought it was polar bear. Is it grizzly?
Oh, I think we're going to go with the grizzly.
Okay, grizzly, you know, that's right. You said grizzly.
I mean, it could
be
polar.
No, it's grizzly.
Grizzly's a little more well-known than
yeah.
The polar bear. Plenty of protection. Now it breaks down, and Toole goes down back at the 27-yard line. 27 of their 34 touchdown and scoring drives this year were under 2 minutes. Cougars made them work. They'll punt the ball. It's a low roller, and it's going to bounce high. There's already a flag down, and
we haven't seen that in a long time by the Duck defense.
During the kick, holding, number 31 of the return team. Penalty will be enforced from the spot where the kick ended. First down.
Haven't been 6-0 since 2002. Of course, the Ducks were 6-0 that year and then just went downhill after that and ended up in the thing that I think is still a figment of my imagination, the Seattle Bowl. I'm not sure that really happened or not.
Yes. I don't want to talk about that whole experience.
It's Wake Forest, is that correct?
That's right.
Yeah.
That's what my dream was like.
That was ugly.
I don't know who they were playing in your dream. LaMichael up the middle. He'll pick up four.
Need to slow LaMichael James at the line of scrimmage.
Here's LaMichael again. Big hole this time. Here's LaMichael. Slips. Flag is down.
It was a no-no.
Offense number 79. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Replay. Second down.
Big guy is getting space to right of your screen. Mark Asper, he's making the block. Now you can't see him, but you'll see him there for a minute. That's a pancake to me. That's not holding.
So, again, another penalty. So the Ducks have to overcome a big hole here. Going to throw it outside. Mail looking for a block. Gets one. And gets across the 20.
Joe, and watch the receivers out front block. 2-and-A. I mean, the receivers block so well. Scott Frost, the receiver coach for the Ducks, has done a great job with the receivers blocking downfield, springing the running backs and the fellow receivers for more yards.
They're down five. See what the Cougars trying to do defensively. They come after them. They'll just rush the four. Over the middle. Dropped by LT, and Oregon will have to punt.
As a receiver, you want to use your hands. Don't allow the ball to get to that body, hit those pads, or hit that belly. It's going to bounce right off.
Long snap. And a nice punt. All the way back to the 27-yard line is Marcus Richmond. And Richmond goes down.
D-line can stop the run and put pressure on the quarterback. Got some good things going on.
Here's first down now. They'll hand the ball off. Still on his feet and dragging for a couple of yards is James Montgomery. Ducks have dominated the last three times these two teams have played. This Washington State team is better than all three of those, I think. Here's two of the throw. Pressure coming. Gets away. Now he's got some room to run and dives out of bounds for the first down.
It's a nice job again. The pressure. Linebackers, Coach Nick Aliotti, D coordinator for Oregon, sending some linebackers, but Toole escaped.
Bucks had a chance to really put him in a bad spot with the defense having been out on the field, but couldn't convert after some penalties. The inside screen. Buck defense is there. I think the ball's on the ground. They're still, they keep trying to unpile him, but they jump in there. And Washington State has the ball.
Well, Marquise Wilson was trying to get some extra yards. And he wasn't down. He was on some bodies. You see the ball right there.
Comes a little pressure again. Tool throws it. Caught for a first down at the 46-yard line into Oregon territory. And the ball up the middle. They're second down and 8. Caught, first down. Cougars driving. They survived the fumble that they recovered themselves. They used to throw again, and this one caught for an 8, making a 7-yard pickup.
Oh, yeah, Cliff Harris was coming on this football. And that's, again, another nice throw.
Big hole. Montgomery to the 10, 5, touchdown Cougars.
He hit that hole so fast. That's what happens when you're running back, by hitting the hole so fast and going north and south. He didn't end up going east and west. Go towards the end zone.
They took it to the Oregon defense area.
No foul on the play for a horse collar tackle. No foul for a horse collar tackle.
Nico Grosso in for the extra point. And his kick is up, and it's good. And the Cougars have pulled it within a point here. 8-7, Oregon with the lead here in the first quarter. Hey, folks, make sure to head down to the Cooler Restaurant and Bar every Tuesday, 7 to 8. Coach Kelly's down there with Jerry Allen. It's Tailgate Tuesday. Have a great time down MLK at the Cooler. I know the Cooler's packed today, full of folks watching. A special welcome to Sarah Dean, Sean Ekstrom, and James Waddell at the Cooler, along with Jonas Kungis, and at the Cooler tonight. Hope you all have a good time there at the Cooler, watching today's Oregon football game against the Cougars. Kenyon Barner just gets blasted, fumbles the ball. The Cougars pick it up and have the ball at the 10-yard line. And Barner's still down.
That was a collision.
It's not a good start for the Ducks. Penalties and turnovers, and boy, let's hope that Kenyon is okay.
Took a shot right to the head. Right across the jaw area.
I mean, people are jacked up right now.
Well, with hits like that, you should be jacked up for the Washington State Cougars. I mean, their fans are fired up.
The stadium was not all that full, and then I think as the Cougars start playing, the dorms are all right around the stadium. I mean, people are still pouring into the stadium. And hopefully Kenyon's going to be okay.
And things like this, when your fellow teammate gets blasted like this, it wakes you up as well.
And I think they need to... They're going to get him out of here over to the hospital pretty soon, I think. They're talking about getting the ambulance out here right away, so this may be more serious than we thought, Anthony. Still down there looking at him. They have him on his back. Chip Kelly's out there as well. A lot of times, you know, they take a lot of precaution, Anthony. They take precaution with the kids to make sure that they're okay. If someone feels some numbness. Or...
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, Kenyon didn't see.
Now Kenyon's mom and dad are down on the field, too. That's his father. Chip Kelly, I think, spending some time trying to calm the parents down a little bit, that maybe there's a precautionary. Of course, I'm being as optimistic as possible. The trainers and everybody are out there.
LaMichael James is very upset. They're very close friends. They work out together. They fellow running backs. And
game is so secondary at this point.
Oh, yes.
And we're very hopeful this is just precautionary. Seasons can turn on a dime. And
well, Mike Bellotti used to say all the time that this is not a contact sport, it's a collision sport. And you got guys weighing, you know, 230 pounds, 200 pounds, colliding at full speed. And watch Kenyon's helmet, his face mask. It looked like a helmet right to the face mask. Turned his helmet almost backwards. So there could be I've seen guys have a broken jaw because of that.
To assure you that Kenyon's going to be okay. His helmet is off. I think you see his arm there. He's sitting up. See him sitting up now. And they're going to help him up onto his own feet. So that's great news with his dad and his mom. Part of what made that hit so big, Anthony, was the acceleration off the block. So it wasn't just a man running at his top speed. It was that plus something.
Yeah. Yeah. And the defender's helmet hit, you know, Kenyon right across the face. And again, I don't think Kenyon even saw him. He was trying to cut back inside.
So they're going to go ahead and take him in for further observation. It's obviously very good news that he was able to stand up on his own power there with onto his feet, move his limbs. There's LaMichael. Again, these kids are...
They're close.
They're 19 years old.
Very close family.
Let's not forget that part. They're 19. 18 and 19-year-old sophomore.
They do everything together on the field and off the field. I remember playing with guys and Derek Lavelle and, you know, Bill Musgrave, all those guys. You're close. You build a bond like no other. And if you see your fellow guy go down like that, it's going to shake you up a little bit. It's going to make you angry. And I, from an ex-player, I know the Ducks right now, they're a little angry. They're a little frustrated. Does it wake them up a little bit? And they still have to play a football game. Make sure Kenyon's okay, but is that the spark that wakes this Duck offense and defense up?
Cougars will have the ball at the 6-yard line. So as the ambulance pulls away here out of Martin Stadium, now the Ducks have to refocus with the Cougars at the 6-yard line after the fumble, and they have a chance to take the lead here in the first quarter. Cougars now with a chance to take the lead. They'll run it on first down and to the 1-yard line. 3:50 in the first quarter. They'll run it again. And over the line or not, the ball is loose. It's a touchdown.
Well, you look on paper and you think, hey, Ducks are the better football team, but this is why you play the game. You got to come out and you got to play. You got to execute.
It's under review.
Well, to look at it. We'll see. This won't give us the line look, but we can at least see about whether the ball did come out. Not the ball. I think you had it. Here's kind of the best look at it here. So there it is. That's a touchdown.
FU, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Extra point attempt is up and good, and Washington State has the lead here. Off his kick, high. It's going to be deep into the end zone, and Huff wants to bring it out and has to take a knee. Second down and 10. A fake to LaMichael. Now they throw it out to the flat, and it's not a good throw behind DJ Davis. Second down and 10. Putting together a long drive. Here's LaMichael James. Taken down for a loss. Third down and 14. Didn't give LaMichael much forward progress on that play. Here comes the safety blitz. Wide open out here is LaMichael James. He has it. James at the foot race. James to the 50. Will he get there? 30. LaMichael James to the 10. 5. Touchdown, Oregon. LaMichael James.
And you'll see that. You can't see the side footage, but LaMichael James wide open, untouched.
And a great call by Mark Helfrich and Chip Kelly to go into that blitz. And LaMichael James with a long touchdown reception. Rob Beard on for the extra point. His kick is up and good, and Oregon is back out in front, 15-14. When they started out, Deion Buchanan had the angle on him, and by the time they got to the 20, he was 4 yards behind him. Beard's kick high, and taken at the 6-yard line. Near side, a good tackle from behind. Cool changes the play. There's going to look and throw back over the middle. Pop. Ducks playing that soft zone, and they're finding the hole. Cougars will run the ball out here. Pick up a couple of yards. The whistle just blew, and then the flag comes out, Anthony. Three flags come down.
After the play, dead ball, personal foul. Number 55, offense. Dead ball, personal foul. Number 11, defense. Penalties offset, second down.
Tools had time to throw. And as you've mentioned, Anthony, they've run the ball enough. Screen pass, now he looks and delivers another strike. Again, they're just sitting down underneath the zone. Full backfield here for the Cougars on third and a yard and a half. And the stop is made short of the first down. It'll be fourth and a yard. See if the Cougars go for fake. They'll kick it. Very high kick. Cliff Harris takes it at the 10. Harris gets through and spins away. And Harris to the 14. And again, Oregon will start from deep in their own territory. James up the middle, head of steam.
And when you're talking about LaMichael James carrying the football, they're going to keep giving him the football inside, 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 and then he may break one.
Ducks go. Cougars weren't ready. Here's Thomas. Wide open is DJ Davis down here, and he doesn't get to it. Ducks lead it by one here with the ball. So big third down and 3 here for Oregon with a double tight end set. They'll give it to LaMichael. He works hard forward and has the first down at the 33. Quick on the ball. Here's LaMichael again. Still working. Second down and 8. LaMichael into the pile for maybe a yard.
I think that's Remine, Austin.
Or Remine, the gentleman is in. Little screen set up. Davis needs a couple blocks, gets one. There goes DJ Davis. Can he keep his feet to the 50?
The rule is if you haven't stopped the play, you keep running it over and over again.
James back in the game. He'll take it to the outside. So second down and 7 here. Here's LaMichael again. This time tries to cut it back. Was on the ground. And
yeah, he was down. And LaMichael's coming out a little bit.
Hip or something. Holding his back. Like just on the side, on his left side. Third down, 4. Here comes the blitz. Thomas keeps it. Thomas gets outside. The crowd thought he was down, and we had flags all over the place.
Holding.
Comes out with an arm.
Number 74.
He's holding his arm down.
10-yard penalty.
His replay. Right arm.
Third down.
Like he has a shoulder.
Well, you'll see at the end of the play, Darren Thomas.
Darren Thomas is
diving for the ball.
Maybe it's his hand. It's his right shoulder, right side. Third and 13. Darren Thomas in a lot of pain. Takes the snap, stands in there, throws it to Jeff Mayle. Picks up a few, and Oregon with fourth and seven. Right arm down across his body.
He pointed to his shoulder.
Field. I think he's got a shoulder problem.
Pointed to his shoulder, so you'll have to check that out.
He goes straight to the bench to sit down. So this possession, the three sophomores now, all some form of an injury. LaMichael, Thomas, and Barner. Rob Beard. Welcome back, everyone. The Ducks trying to handle some injuries. Kenyon Barner is at the hospital for observation. LaMichael James went down after he hurt his hip, his left side. And now Darren Thomas heading to the locker room after coming up with a right arm, either shoulder or arm, on the far side of the field. So it's going to be Nate Costa next time out. And this is a completion across the 30. Tool having some success throwing the ball around. There's Costa. He'll be likely out there next time Oregon gets the ball. Cougars again having some success throwing the ball. This one's thrown into the zone. Complete again. There is a flag down this time.
Holding. Offense. Number 77. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay. Second down. Look.
Again, the receivers are right in the pocket. Might have got a knee taken out. Physical game today.
Last year when the Ducks played Washington State, Jeremiah Masoli was injured in that game. Here's the run. And going to lose a couple yards back to the 20. Second down and 22. Going deep, but not enough time.
That's 6 yards.
Third down, 28 for the Cougars. They spread it out here on third and 28. Best way to defend this ball, which might be a long ball, is to get there. He set up a little screen pass and missed the tackle and back across the field. And the Cougars will have to punt now from their 18-yard line. Big kick. Cliff Harris watches it bounce. Now he takes it at the 35. Gets by one guy. Here's Harris to the outside. Harris needs one more block. It's the kicker in the way. Cliff Harris following the blockers into the end zone. Touchdown! Cliff Harris again!
Boy, Joe, playmakers.
The Cougars have a man down who has not moved yet.
He hasn't moved at all. And look at the blocks that Cliff Harris got downfield. Then he has a group of guys, white jerseys right in front of him. It's a nice job by Cliff Harris finding the hole.
And the Ducks now lead it 21-14. Cliff Harris's third touchdown, returning punts this year. Beard's extra point is up and through, and the Ducks are back to an 8-point lead with 8:25 to go here in the second. 42-14 is our score here in Pullman. The Duck Band has made their way over here to cheer on the Ducks, the number 3 ranked team in the country. Welcome back, everyone. Cliff Harris, there's the one guy that misses, and there he goes.
Again, he gets to that second level, Joe. Great vision downfield, hard to bring down, and a lot of speed.
Rob Beard kicks it off. And the Cougars will just take a knee. Big hole up the middle. Montgomery. Jeff Toole is 8 of 9 already in the game. Throws it across in the air and almost intercepted on the tip by Casey Matthews.
Nice job by Casey Matthews. Coming to get that tip. Tips and overthrows. That's what I tell my defensive backs. Most interceptions happen because of tips and overthrows. Cliff Harris had a chance, Anthony Gildon had a chance.
Let's see if Thomas is going to come in or if it's going to be Nate Costa, but they'll have to wait to find that out because the Cougars convert on third down. Again, their offense looks a heck of a lot like Arizona with that short passing game. They're just finding guys 3, 4, 5 yards down the field. Now they'll run it. It's not Montgomery this time.
Mitz.
It's Mitz. Well, Michael looks like he's had enough rest to get over whatever was bothering him. They'll throw it to the outside. A lot of blockers out there, and there. There's a big hit on the outside.
When the Ducks were outmatched, they had three receivers out there right away. Receivers are cut blocking, and that is a hit by Javis Lewis.
In the game last year, Washington State had four in the entire game when they played in Eugene. Cool, having to get away now, looking down the field, throws it deep. He's got a man out there, and it is incomplete. Boy, he threw that a long ways off his back foot, didn't he?
Sure did. He has a strong arm. He's a big guy, about 6'3".
Cougars will lose a couple yards on the run here.
When you have to get 13 yards, it takes a little bit longer to find that zone. So you hope that the offensive line can hold up and give Tool time to find that open receiver.
Ducks with three down linemen. Now they'll bring Eddie Pleasant from the outside. He tries to get around the corner. Thrown down the middle and caught by Wilson at the 23.
Well, this is a great catch by Wilson, diving.
Maybe the Ducks are going to have to outscore him today. Quick on the ball. Mitz is a flag down. We'll pick up a yard.
Poitnet, his guy.
Offense, number 54. 10-yard penalty. Replay, first down.
And again, he's had big games. He went over 100 at UCLA last week. Tool, plenty of time. Throws it down the field. Looking for Wilson, and incomplete. Peppers comes out, and Cliff Harris comes in on the far side. This is second down and 20. See if the Ducks can get to him. Over the middle, and it is almost intercepted by Cliff Harris. Again, he almost had that in his hands.
Cliff Harris. With the instinct to jump in front of the football right there and almost make the play. It's a lockdown corner, number 13.
Just barely got through his hands. Third and long here at the 32. Nico Grasso's got a big leg, so this is definitely within his range. He kicked a 56-yarder last week. Cougars only need 20 to pick up the first down. See if the Ducks can get to him here, Anthony. Bringing some outside pressure. Down the middle. He's got a receiver out there and then complete.
That time, the offensive line is doing a great job for Tool, giving him time to throw this football in.
They need sevens, but now they'll send Grasso out. This one's going to be into the wind. And it's going to be a 50-yarder. Here's the snap. It's low. Grasso's kick is on the way, and it is good. 50-yarder. 22-17. Enthusiastic Duck fans, but right now, this is anybody's game. Coming up, it's our AT&T Halftime Report. AT&T is the official wireless provider of Oregon Athletics. AT&T, rethink possible. Who sends this one a couple yards deep. Huff's going to bring it out. Here comes the freshman Josh Huff. Tries to get outside, but only gets back to the 17-yard line. LaMichael James is the tailback. So Costa's in the game. Thomas is talking with the coaches. He came back out of the locker room. So Nate Costa now running the offense. He's going to throw it. Looking for DJ Davis and has a completion out across the 30.
A dart to Davis.
Darren Thomas with his helmet off and still holding that arm. Standing here just down in front of us on the 50-yard line. He's not moving his arm. They throw it to the outside to Davis and tries to make a move and picks up about 4 yards on the play. His right side, his right arm. But when he came out of the locker room, he was running. So it was like he didn't want to miss anything. Here's Costa. He pick up 3 yards.
Nate Costa could do some very good things as well in this offense. He's been around a long time.
Big play here, Anthony. Big play. And there's an offsides, I think, on the Cougars.
Offside.
Jumped the gun.
Number 89. 5-yard penalty. Penalty will result in a first down.
Costa going to throw it. Plenty of time. Throws it to the outside. Davis makes the catch. See where they mark it. Should be about an 8-yard pickup. They mark it back at the 49.
Some serious speed on the ball.
Big hole up the middle. James close to a first down. Ducks quick on the ball. Costa keeps it, has a big hole. Here's Costa. Costa outside. Nate to the 30. Nate Costa to the 20. The 10. 5 is the end. No, he gets down to the 1-yard line.
I think he's hobbling because he hasn't ran that long in a long time. Nate Costa, great job with the stiff arm. Big legs that Nate Costa has. Allows him to get down the field and just short of the first down, touchdown.
Costa still with it. He gets down close to the one.
Dead ball, personal foul, defense, number 12. Penalty will be half the distance to the goal and an automatic first down.
That last penalty on number 12, C.J. Mizell, can't afford to do that. You can't beat yourself.
First and goal from the one. They'll give it to LaMichael. He's still on his feet, and he's into the end zone for his third touchdown of the day.
Just power, power, power.
His kick is up and straight through.
And again, look at LaMichael James. Stops the line of scrimmage, bounces off, keeps the legs moving, has a nose for the end zone.
Barton and Winston are deep for the Cougars. This one's going to come down to Carl Winston deep in the end zone. So you can see the wind a little bit there on how the kickoffs are being affected. This is a big, big series. Ducks bringing some pressure. Tool, and it's incomplete.
You take a chance when you throw to a ball hawk.
Second down and 10. They'll just rush three this time. Out into the flat, incomplete. Third down and 10.
And they have to pick this first down up, Joe, because you don't want Oregon to get the ball again with 2 minutes left in the half.
Tool, plenty of time. Throws it, but too high, incomplete. Low kick.
That's
bounced
kick.
Right to Cliff Harris. He's going to try to get it up the middle. Now go outside. Still on his feet. Harris turns around. Harris is still up. Now he goes down at the 47. Great field position with 148 after a very successful first drive. He hands it off to LaMichael James, who follows blockers for nearly 5 yards. 138, all three timeouts.
Again, the power of LaMichael James. And when you watch LaMichael James, Joe, he gets stronger and stronger as the game goes on.
Plenty of time for Costa. Looks, throws it into some heavy coverage.
Holding, offense, number 74. Ten-yard penalty will be enforced in the previous spot. Replay, second down.
Second down, 15 for Costa. 1:23 on the clock, and now another whistle.
Prior to the snap, false start. Number 68, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Thus with their sixth penalty in the first half.
You see to the right of your screen, C.E. Kaiser just flinched just a little bit.
A little inside screen to Jeff Mail. Mail gets hit, stays on his feet somehow.
Jeff Mail will take a blow. He's a tough kid, an ex-safety, played safety for the Ducks when he first got here. I don't think you can hurt number 23.
That was the last guy there, too. That was it. Third and long for Oregon here with 54 seconds in the half. Costa back to throw. Throws it underneath the Mail. He spins away from one guy, but that's not going to get you the chains moving. And down to 3, 2, 1. And then go ahead and take the penalty. Took it all the way down to 4 seconds.
Timeout, Oregon. Your first charge timeout of the half.
I always think the best way to defend these are send all your linebackers, because the linebackers aren't doing anything. They're just, the ball's going to go 50 yards over their heads. So you might as well rush them. There's Costa rolling. Now set up and throw it all the way down to the end zone, and it is incomplete. And that will take us to halftime.